Comets can do some pretty serious damage when they hit planets. We know this because they've caused doomsday scenarios when they've hit Earth. But today, we're not talking about what would happen if a comet hit a planet, we are talking about what would happen if a comet hit the sun. Considering comets are massive balls of ice and rock, most of the time, when comets pass by the sun, they wither away and essentially melt into nothing. But what if a comet big enough happened to hit the sun? What exactly would happen? Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, what would happen if a comet hit the sun? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life, and occasionally, we answer them too. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and I would just like to thank you all again for helping this channel get remonetized. Your kind words made us feel so supportive, and we are so happy to be back in business making videos for you. So with that being said, if you are new here, hit that subscribe for more daily questions, and don't forget to stick around until the end of the video where we respond to users' comments. Comets, as I said, are big blocks of ice and rock that travel around the solar system. Comets get their tails from solar winds. Comet tails are actually the ice in a comet melting. Most of the comets in our solar system are quite far away from us. They hang out in the Oort cloud, which is on the outer reaches of the solar system past Neptune. Just so you know, Jack Finch and I are starting a band called the Oort cloud. We're actually not, but I feel like that's a pretty good band name. But the comets that do manage to make it to the inner solar system and get close to the sun are called sun grazers. Sun grazer comets pass by the sun at a rate of 3 or 4 a week. That's according to NASA's Solar and Heliospheric Observatory. Carl Badhams, expert at the US Naval Research Lab in Washington, D.C., said if you're a loosely packed snowball, then going to the sun is something you should probably try to avoid. Thanks, Carl. I'll tell that to all my massive snowball friends. It actually isn't the sun's outer layer that melts the comets as they graze past it. The outer layer of the sun is called the corona. It's pretty hot, but very thin. Too thin to transfer a lot of heat. It's actually the glare caused by solar radiation that sublimates ice into gas, eventually escaping into space, or causing the comet to break apart. The size of a comet actually changes depending on how close they are to the sun. As a comet ventures near our star, the ice on its surface vaporizes to form a cloud called a coma. This coma could be as large as 50,000 miles. The sun, however, does not have a surface. It's literally a gigantic spinning ball of gas and fire, mostly hydrogen. But scientists have recently observed a comet called Lovejoy passed through the sun's corona, still together on the other side. It was worn down, mind you, but still intact. Kinda like Frosty the Snowman on a warm day. But you're not here to find out what would happen if a comet grazed past the sun. You're here for the good stuff. You're here to find out what would happen if a comet hit the sun. I'm not sure if you noticed, but the sun is a really, really big object. It's entirely possible for a comet to hit the sun because there's plenty of objects flying around the solar system, and the sun, according to NASA stargazer Carl Badhams, is a pretty big target. Astronomer John Brown calls comets that hit the sun supersonic snowballs in hell. Quite fitting if you ask me. Also a good band name. I really gotta talk to Jack about this. He says that a comet would have to have a mass of at least 10 kilograms to hit the sun's lower atmosphere. If a comet is big enough and gets close enough to the sun, it would engage in a steep fall into the sun's gravity and begin to accelerate, reaching 600 kilometers per second. This would effectively flatten the comet into a pancake thanks to drag from the sun's lower atmosphere. Then once it hits the sun, it will explode in an airburst, also releasing ultraviolet radiation and X-rays that we can actually see with specialized modern instruments. The explosion from a comet hitting the sun would unleash the same amount of energy as a magnetic flare, or something called a coronal mass ejection. Essentially, according to John Brown, it would be like a bomb being released in the sun's atmosphere. He also says that the momentum propelled by the comet could make the sun ring like a bell, with sunquakes echoing through the solar atmosphere. That being said, a comet hitting the sun poses absolutely no threat to Earth, but they do look pretty cool. This type of event doesn't happen very often, probably once a century. What Brown is saying is only an educated guess. No one has actually observed a comet hitting the sun closely. And that makes sense because only in the last couple of decades have we developed the technology to observe such an event. Apparently though, back in October of 2011, the Solar and Heliospheric Observatory captured footage of a comet hitting the solar surface of the sun, and shortly afterward there's a big explosion. Scientists aren't sure if these two events were correlated because the explosion actually occurred on the opposite side of the sun, far away from where the comet actually hit. Another reason why it's so rare for a comet to get near the sun is because of the sun's gravitational forces, its Roche limit. The sun's gravitational forces rip apart comets that are structurally weak. It takes a really strong tick with 2 C's comet to actually make it to the sun's upper atmosphere, let alone a comet tick enough to cause an explosion. Yes, I just called a comet tick. Are you mad about it? I don't think you are. Well, there you have about it. You just heard what would happen if a comet hit the sun. I hope you enjoyed hearing about it as much as I enjoyed researching it. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some common features from my last video, What If You Shot a Gun Underwater? Bobby Brick said, are you guys monetized again?
Yes, Bobby, we are.
Jamin said, I love LBQ, I'm a very curious guy and this channel quenches my curious mind. Well, we have plenty of videos to quench your thirst. Rotten Rainbow said, I subscribe because of Charlotte. I like you. That is it for me, and thanks for watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you will love the playlist that's currently flashing on your screen. And don't forget to leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, subscribe for more, and I will see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.